How do you know if an idea is worth pursuing? Companies need tried and true ways to discover the next big idea that will disrupt their industry. We've created this idea testing presentation template that includes tools such as dog fooding, Wizard of Oz, multivariate test, phase rollout, longitudinal study, and many more that can be downloaded and customized to different business scenarios. Let's review how these tools work, and then how each one can provide a framework for brainstorming and testing new ideas. Before the iPhone keyboard design became something billions of people use every day, Apple employees first tested the waters. They used it in their daily lives as if they were real-life users. Dog fooding is a way to test ideas with internal team members. Get honest feedback quickly from your own employees first so you know if you're on the right track. This word cloud represents employees' responses to an idea or prototype. Compile these adjectives to see what people are saying at a glance. The bigger the word, the more common the sentiment. How can you gauge user opinion on a new product without spending resources to build the whole thing? With the Wizard of Oz tool, create a mock-up of how a product or feature would function, but without any real technical input. Think of it as a facade. On the left here is the mock-up. On the right are the findings. For example, see what potential customers think of chatbot responses without actually programming the bot. In this case, a team member would respond to customer inquiries manually, pretending to be the bot, but you get real-time data. Sometimes it pays to test multiple solutions at once. Use the multivariate test tool to neatly structure the performance of different product iterations. Before starting the experiment, make sure to identify what metrics you want to measure. These are the numbers that will determine which idea is the winner. First, list the control of the experiment. This is the current version that customers have been seeing. Then, list the variations you're testing. In most cases, it'd help to add a picture of what the variation looks like. At the end of the experiment, calculate if the solution actually increased the performance. Note the improvement, or lack thereof, in the boxes on the right. All that's left is to pick a winner and proceed. Imagine this. You're about to launch a new product feature. You give every user access all at once. What if something goes wrong? In most cases, it's not a question of if, but when. Unfortunately, something almost always goes wrong. Worst case scenario, you release a bad, unreliable product to every one of your customers at the same time, and then naturally, they flee to your competitors. Not good. Instead of all that, companies will often test a new launch via what's called a phase rollout. This is to dip their toes in and feel for any unforeseen mistakes or bugs. Break down the rollout into phases, and what percentage of the users will actually receive the new release and at what phase. If all goes well, then proceed to the next phase. Otherwise, fix any hiccups before rolling out to more users. In this example, the rollout is in phase 6, with 50% of the user base already receiving it. At the bottom, highlight success metrics such as adoption rate and crash-free sessions. Remember, if you like the tools in this presentation, you can download and customize them for your needs right now. I'm still waiting. Did you do it? Now, what if you want to track customer behavior or sentiment? That's where the longitudinal study tool comes in. Where other tools in this presentation are best for making sense of metrics, like numbers of click-throughs, this tool is used to add context to such data. In other words, adding the why. Also known as a diary study, longitudinal studies are great for tracking the intention and meaning of user behavior in their natural environments across time. Because these tests usually take longer to plan and execute, it's helpful to have a timeline that everyone can follow, all the way from initial planning to the actual logging process and through to the post-study interview. One of the most commonly used methods in digital product development is the usability test tool, which assesses how different subjects perform given different tasks. Use this tool to see how intuitive your products are. You may design a customer journey for your new app. How smooth do people find each step of the experience? Subjects are scored from 1 to 3 on a list of tasks they're given. Use these results to get a total usability score for each subject. If you're a social media company, examples might be uploading an image or sharing a post with a friend. Usually, usability tests are more effective with 5 subjects. After that, they tend to have diminishing returns. Similarly, the System Usability Scale, or SUS, obtains individual responses to survey questions. It then uses these responses to calculate a total usability score for each question. The scores for each question are calculated in this slide, using the numbers from this one. Where previous tools track the performance of tasks, this one documents user sentiment about overall usability. If the last tool revealed how easily subjects perform tasks like uploading an image, this tool will tell you how they feel about those tasks. Stay on the cutting edge by generating and stress testing ideas with this idea testing presentation, which you can download and customize for your needs right now. After that, go check out our video on the Design Sprint Framework for a tool to brainstorm and test major breakthroughs in only 5 days. Thanks for watching.